Welcome everyone, I'm Juhi and we're sitting here with an Urban Asian favorite of ours, Mr. Jay Sean. Jay,
what's how are you up? Doing? Good, what's up everyone?
Great, and you know, I got to interview you last year and it was so much fun. I'm so glad that we're back.
Yes.
Here again talking, and it's actually my birthday today.
Happy birthday!
Thank you so much.
What do you guys wish a happy birthday right now? Nice.
I heard it, thank you. Nice. So last year we were talking to you about Hit the Lights, which featured Lil Wayne.
Yes.
And now this year we're talking to you about your single, I'm All Yours, which
yes.
is going to be featuring Pitbull, another amazing artist. So mm-hmm. tell us about this song.
Right through ya, four lawsuits, 1 year, two down, two to go, fame expensive, yeah, good thing.
Well, the song is uplifting, it's up-tempo, it's fun, it's definitely a dance record. It's got a romantic element about it and it's melodic. And that for me was very important because if you switch on the radio now, you hear it's all, that's all it seems to be. And I'm like, I'm not going to do that. I want to do something which people know me for. They know me for my melodic songs, they know me for my thread of romance, they know me for also, yeah, making people feel good. So that's what it is. And, you know, it's just a beautiful record. It's got a very global sound about it. This is a total and utter summer feeling record, like that when the sun's blazing and you're in your car, you're on the windows down, roof down, whatever it is, barbecues, whatever, it's that vibe, you know, and that's what I wanted, that's why I came with this one.
Perfect timing, and especially we're here in New York right now, and a place that's very close to your heart.
Yeah.
And the weather's been getting so much nicer
right.
recently, and so
right.
it's perfect timing. And I know
exactly.
that it's definitely going to be one of those theme songs.
Exactly, it's also a good workout song.
Yes.
You know, it's just one of those where it just makes you just gets you out.
Yeah, definitely. And now you worked with Pitbull on this song.
Mm-hmm.
Now Pitbull's another artist such as yourself who's kind of crossed it into different types of song music genres. And so how do you feel about working with someone who, although very different from yourself,
mm-hmm.
is also has worked in that sort of?
Well,
song.
That's why I worked with him, because I was like, you know, we share a similar fan base. There's a lot of people who might like Pitbull, and they're like, oh yeah, I like Jay Sean as well, because you can put it in the same playlist, the same track listing. But you know, really the collaboration came about very organically. It came about because we were actually on tour in Australia together. And we just got talking and, you know, fan of each other's music, and this one thing led to another, and we're like, yo, let's just do a song together. Yeah, cool, let's do it. Pitbull's such a nice guy. I mean, such a down-to-earth, great guy to work with, super easy guy. So it was nice to be able to have him bless myself. The most important thing, really, for me, though, is to work with someone whose energy is right. I can't work with somebody whose energy doesn't fit, because it will translate on the song. You have to have a respect for each other, a love for each other's music, for you to be able to work together. When you're doing a song together, it's like, you know, it's two artists coming together. You have to drop your egos. You both have to just live in the same space. And that takes certain type of people to be able to do that.
That's great, thanks. And now, your album, another question presented by Secret Beat, through your album that this song is in, how would you describe that album in three words?
Go get it.
Go get it, that's perfect. And so, now, what else makes this album special besides this song?
Well, the album, I mean, really, when I do an album, for me, the one thing I'm always thinking is, I don't ever want it to be a collection of songs that I think are going to be hits. Because then it's not an album, it's a compilation album, okay? That's not what I want. I want to take you on a journey. I want there to be songs that might never be a single, but it might end up being your favorite song. It might be number 9 on the album, you're like, oh, I love that song. But it might not be a single. But whatever, it gets you here and you live it. I still believe in living with an album. I still believe in falling in love with a piece of work. Not just skipping through, don't like it. How do you know? You haven't even heard it yet. You heard the first 10 seconds. Like, sometimes these albums, they have to grow on you. Each song says something different. There are songs that are going to make you cry. There are songs that are going to be super sexy. There's songs which make you feel great, amplified, ready for work, ready for school, whatever it is. Other songs that make you want to play, you can't wait to play it the minute you finish work, because it's just like, ah, that's my jam right there, you know. So I wanted to be able to do that and put together a body of work, and I feel like I've done that really well myself.
Great, and now when you have such a personal tie to your music, how do you balance that out with the industry and how you kind of have to go through
yeah,
the system?
100%. Look, here's what it is, you know, I'd be lying if I said that you could be an artist nowadays who just sings a song that's so beautiful, thought-provoking, blah blah blah, instantly it's gonna be a hit. It's not that given anymore. There's very few artists out there in the music industry at the moment who are able to sing from the heart about what they want to sing about and not have to conform to the current trends in music. And those artists are blessed to be able to do that. There's a lot of artists who don't ever, they might be amazing artists from back in the day who can't even get on radio anymore because they're not current enough. And then there's other artists, you know, who just know how to lead the way. They know what's current, they know what's happening, they're ahead of the curve, they're staying on there. Like Pitbull is one of those. He's ruling, he's just ruling. He's like, I know what's working, I'm gonna keep doing this because this is my thing, my lane right here. Mm-hmm. And that's, you know, I think it's great. I think you just gotta know what you do and do it well.
Now, you've been touring and performing globally, and one thing that I was extremely intrigued by was that you performed with Folk Studios in Lebanon.
Right.
And that's something that I personally, and so many others, feel is such a great platform because it's so intimate and it's just so raw. Mm-hmm. How did you personally feel performing?
I loved it. I absolutely loved that whole experience. It was so good. I actually prefer performing acoustic. That's my favorite way of performing. Just strip it down, a voice and an instrument. There's nothing, you can't hide behind it. There's no auto tune, there's no fancy tricks. It's just, you know, raw music. I love that. But also the fun experience was, you know, working with another artist. Again, I just love the experience of two people who do what they do best, but coming together, two minds. Imagine Beethoven and Mozart together, you know, doing a composition. Imagine Picasso and Van Gogh trying to paint a painting together, like, oh, I think let's do this. It's just amazing. So when two artists come together and try to do something like that, you just, it's just a flow of energy and creativity, and that's what, you know, you guys should watch that if you ever get a chance. When it hits the internet, you guys will be able to see that. It's really cool. So, you know, me and an Egyptian artist, we both came and tried to fuse our song. We picked the song and tried to fuse our different way of singing and different styles and music and instruments to do that song together. Live as well, not in the studio, live.
That kind of process is so beautiful, especially for performing artists, because you really get to play with other artists, you get to play with the instruments, you get to play with your audience, and it's amazing. And now, what is something that you can tell us that is your own special, unique creative process that defines you?
I don't overthink anything. I can't. I'm all 100% heart and guts. That's all I'm made of. So whatever it is, when I'm writing a song, I don't overthink, go with my heart.
Thank you so much. I know Urban is
happy birthday.
Thank you so much.
Yes, let's do it. Yeah, what's up? I'm Jay Sean, and you are watching me right here on UrbanAsian.com.